Hello. Is this thing on? I'm gagging. Now, never in the history of my channel or anything that I've done that I've talked about a country, song, nor artist, nor situation. So this is going to be very interesting. I don't know what to really say, but I'm gagging. The first thing that comes to mind, unfortunately, is I wanna wake up in Texas. The sea is no place for a squirrel. I wanna go home. I wanna go home. Hey y'all, what the f is T-Bitches? Yes, we are back up in this gig. We just do Bop and Flop at this channel at this point. The days change, cause things change. Okay. I'm stressed. So just another day in America, you know, racial injustice and things of that nature and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, another day in America. Home of the brave. Billboard, which is like, you know, if you know what Billboard is, you know what Billboard is, girl. I hope you do. You should know what Billboard is. Well, if you don't, Billboard is the place where the sales and the charts, girl, the charts. Rank and pop, it's a popularity contest to show you what songs are being played and streamed the most. Moving on. So there's different charts and stuff in the world, and there's different categories, just like there's different genres of music. Very self-explanatory, right? Moving on. So Billboard came out and snatched some songs down and said, well, this set song that we're about to listen to is not country enough. And I was like, or this is not qualified as country. So I was like, oh, well, maybe they have a point. So I don't know. Well, okay, moving on. I'm stressed. You see how stressed I am. So basically, Billboard snatched down this black boy song that was intended to be country, labeled as country, but it was not. Billboard declared it wasn't country. So everybody was like, oh my God, Billboard's racist, things of this nature. What else is new with big companies? Black Twitter caught it up, made it a blaze of a flame. And of course I was like, well, okay. Yeah, oh, I can see this being a racist situation. Like, oh, black men. Well, not really, okay. I'm on the fence. I don't know if it's racist. I don't wanna call everything racist because I wanna listen to the song first. And like, if the song does not sound country, girl. But even if it's, you know what I mean? Like, even if it's, you can't put a Bentley sticker on a BMW and say, oh, this is a BMW. I mean, this is a Bentley. Does that make sense? Like, even if you title the song as country and it's clearly not country, then it's like, we can't, what do we do? Like, that, we can't put you on a country chart. However, comma, a new form of country, like country rap, maybe, and they took it down because this baby is doing trap music with rap, which is not, it has been kind of done, like Nelly done in the past and stuff like that. So like, I'm not saying like black people can't do country, like that's not the thing. Like this, clearly there's black country artists, so that's not the thing here. I don't know, it's just, I'm all over the place with this. You know what I mean? Yeah. But his name is Lil Nas. Lil Nas. Lil Nas? Lil Nas. I don't know how I feel about that, because isn't it spelled the same way as Nas? I don't know. I hope Lil Nas. Well, okay. Oh, I don't know how I feel about that. Well, Lil Nas teamed up with Billy Ray Cyrus. Billy Ray Cyrus, I guess, saw the injustice and was like, well, let me hop on the track. You know, Miley Cyrus kind of orchestrated the situation. And I was like, okay, this is a sickening. By the way, go ahead and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, you should go ahead and subscribe. Go, you know, go and find me on Instagram, find me on Twitter too. You know, as Zach Campbell, you know, just subscribe, girls, right here. You know, just if you've never seen my face before, I would love to see you here. Just, I'll give you a second. Just go ahead and scroll. Just like a little, boom. All right, moving on. So they team up with Billy Ray Cyrus. Billy Ray Cyrus hops on this track, which I live for. And I was like, okay, well, let's see what this, what, okay. Well, maybe this make it go on the country chart. So then Billboard tweeted and said like, oh, bitch, okay, like, okay, you see the track. And then Lil Nas was like, well, girl, oh, now you wanna pay attention to me. And of course, I've heard that, and I see that Lil Nas was like, oh, Lil Nas, I keep calling him Lil Nas, ooh. Lil Nas is not, I don't know if he was a rapper for real before all of this. I think he was like a Twitter meme person or whatever. Like, I don't think he even was, I was told that he was a meme. Like, he was just doing this to see what happens. Like, he just wanted to see if he could make it. Damn, is that what music is now for people? But yeah, so, you know, I don't know if this is a real musician that's really struggling with this situation, or it could just be a boy from the internet that made it poppin' and now here we are. I don't know. I don't know. But I'm here to talk about this, because if this is racial injustice, billboard, you're late. But if it's not and it was a misunderstanding, okay. I just feel like sometimes, and this is just a quick little deep moment. I just feel like sometimes we have to stop putting the race card on so many things so quickly as my people, and do a little research first. Cause it is like, well, hold on. For my pro black folk back there in the back, I went to HBCU, so I know exactly how this goes. I'm just saying that yes, there are fucked up people out there, and yes, there are people that are very ignorant. However, everything is not what it seems. Does that make sense? Like, if something is like a little like, man, girl, let's do some research first before we put a whole bandana up and be, like a whole banner up and be like, billboard's racist. And it's like, well, hold on, boy, hold up. Wait a minute, though. But wait, are they? All right, without further puss ado, let's see. I'll pull it up. Wait, I just put up his Spotify. Is it? I'm confused. Is it Lil Nas? Lil Nas X? I don't know. Okay. 69 million streams? Wow. Oh, he's. And it's called Old Time Road? That's that. But where is. I'm sorry. He only has one song. Wait, like one actual song. Like that, there's no other, he has no discography. Like this is not even, like this is, like he only has one song. This is it. And it just came out in April. Oh wait, no, the other song came out before this. All right, wait, I'm just trying to, okay, wow. He has nothing else going. Like, at least, is he like a brand spanking? Like, is this really just like a Twitter poll and it's just, well, bitch, let me make a song and let me release something and let Billy Ray Cyrus hop on my track. Wow. Well, I'm sorry, I just had a moment. I had to gag. Well, let's see if Lil Nas X and Billy Ray Cyrus's Old Town Road is a bop or a flop.
To the left.
Yeah, it's not really a flop because the bitch is popping right now, so there must be something. Let's see. All right, let me pull her up. Let me see what she giving. Give me a second. I just had the urge to twerk for horses. Wow. Wait, what? What happened? What is this? What is this witchcraft? I really was about to twerk for a horse. I need to, bitch, I ain't got no horses in the back, bitch. Not a saddle, not a ranch. But bitch, I almost shook these thighs. Bitch, what if strippers come and I want a stripper to do this? I want a stripper to do this song. On absolutely what a
I got the horses in the back, it's mad at black. Got the boots with black paint on a horse. Track
okay. Wait a minute. Wow. 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 Why is it such a bop? If this is, okay, did the rich, okay, okay, wait. Let me see something real quick. Let me just see something. Oh, that's him too. Oh, he sings like this. Oh, well, Billboard, y'all are just late. I've got to call Billboard out. I'm sorry. Bitch, that is country. If I didn't think it was country, I got the horses and the bag, bitch. Baby, did this little boy go to somebody's house? This baby went to somebody's house, said, I want to make a beat. I need you to make me a country beat. Pull up Shania Twain samples. Give me a sample of her. Put an 808 behind it. And we about to do this up in here. All right, girl, what do I want to wake up in Texas. This place is no place for a squirrel. All right, let me remix that. And say, I got the horses in the back, got the cow on a tractor. That sounds country, right? All right, let's write that up on here. Girl, I got the horses in the bag. Girl. Yeah, that's country. And then it just got popular because it's a popping ass song. Bitch, Iris really just got my life. I really just got my entire life. Absolutely, wow.
Hat down, cross town, living like a rock star. See on my brand new guitar.
It's Billy Ray Cyrus. Come on. Ride till I can't no more. Ride till I can't no more. Why? No, you know what? This is sickening. You know what? You know what, Lil Nas, I live for you. I give this a bop. I'm sorry. I have to give this a bop. As much, even if this is, and my mind is so shifted from the beginning of this video, honestly. Even if this is just a boy that was just like, this would be funny, like this would be, like what if I trolled, you know, the country audience or like people that listen to country, that's so sickening. And it did it well. It's not a bad song. Even the original is not bad. It's funny. It's like, but it's good. Like I dance and it's like, it actually makes sense. And then Billy Ray on it makes it even sickening. And then it's just like, oh, now what if he gets to the CMAs? Oh, this would be cunt. Oh, he should be at the CMAs. Oh, this is sickening. This is sickening. All right, Tyler, so let me know in the comments below what you guys think about this. I think this is a genius thing. I think this is funny. I think this is hilarious. And I think this is sickening. You know what I mean? Like, absolutely. Why not? Why not? All right, Titus, I'm gonna love you guys for watching. As always, I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one. If you watch some more videos over here, you can. Yeah. Wow.